I get this question actually many times, and people ask me, can I learn malware analysis and penetration testing at the same time? Can I find a job using malware analysis skills and penetration testing skills? Well, the answer is between yes and no. If you are starting in your career in malware analysis, and that's your focus, then you need to invest the majority of your time in malware analysis. The bigger circle outside of malware analysis is the blue team in general, which is the incident response, digital forensics, memory forensics, threat hunting, and threat intelligence, and all this circle around. If you focus mainly on blue team, then you can actually get a job in malware analysis or in incident response or in threat hunting much faster. But if your focus is on penetration testing, then learning malware analysis wouldn't really help you to move forward. You can focus on learning red teaming or cloud attacks or even red team weaponization or adversary simulation where you can simulate real attacks. But after you have enough knowledge, and now I wouldn't say enough knowledge, but if you after you become more an advanced level and you are actually working professionally in a company, this is when the bridging starts to happen. Because once you are really in a good level in blue team, you will need to understand the attacker mindset so you can see the attack from a holistic point of view. So, this is how the attackers actually plan his attack. I have been studying incident response for quite some time. I have been studying malware analysis and threat hunting. I know how detection works. I know how security controls work. But now I can see how the attacker actually plan his attack and bypasses defenses and bypasses detection as well. Now I can adjust my detections and my defenses to match with these attacks. Now I can see how the red team will look at my defenses so I can actually improve them and better protect my organization. When there's a purple team exercises and working with somebody else from the red team, now I know how I can communicate with him, how I can actually improve the company's security posture using my experience in red teaming or in the attacker side. The same when it comes to the penetration testing. If you are working in the offensive and you are actually working in penetration testing, you have done multiple penetration testing assessments, you have also learned about red teaming, you are actually simulating real attacks. Now you can look at, okay, this is how the detection team, how's the SOC team actually detecting my attacks. This is how they plan their alerts, this is how they improve their detection, this is how they do forensics, this is how they do memory forensics, this is how they do in-depth investigation. Now, how I can plan my attack to leave no traces, to bypass their detections, to bypass their defenses, and able to improve my attack. So, there is a point in your career where learning the other side will be very beneficial. And at the end of the day, both of you is trying to defend against advanced EBT attacks or target ransomware attacks, which is the same. You understand the attack, either you simulate it or you write detections about it, but you both understand this attack. You both try to learn the attacker's tactics, and procedures, and how they craft their attack. So from both sides, you will have lots of knowledge in common. So there is a point in your career that you will need to learn about the other side. But if you are starting in your cybersecurity career, then I wouldn't advise you to learn both the offense and defense at the same time. Focus on one field, focus on blue team or red team, and dive into that until you reach a level where you are actually working in a professionally in a company, if you're in offensive or in defensive side. And after a specific level, you would say, okay, learning the other side could be very beneficial. Hope that answers your question, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.